down there. This is holding my can, so I don't need even screws. This is a very durable material. This is heavy. That's heavy stuff. That one can be anything, because this is just to hold the air in place. Now, I've got enough space down there, because my container cannot sink down.
Sure.
It's got air. Because the original design was with screws, and I mean, you don't get screws, and then these things, they bend, and nightmare. It's always a nightmare. We need to make these things producible, so that they become affordable and foolproof to use. There's nothing foolproof, but you can try to limit abuse. Abuse is the enemy of use. Okay? So you have to try to get more to a better use, and if you make things that are then easy to do and sort of like self-understanding. So this would be now for the handles. We will fit a piece of wood in here so that you don't burn your knuckles. We did that, but I wouldn't have made to fit it in my suitcase with the handle on. So because I only had 20 kgs of luggage allowance and just one little suitcase that I came with all that stuff. So
the primary air
goes.
Yeah, but there is
the bottom.
There is a calculation on how many holes in order to the.
In
width?
General, from the, what do you call that, in stoichiometry or something like that, from what you would need, it's 1/6 of the secondary air that you need to for a complete combustion. 1/6, but it depends on the size and the shape and the density of your fuel. So if you have a very lightweight fuel with lots of air gaps in between, you probably need less holes. It's a little bit like. Is it good enough to work? Don't let the perfect get in the way of the usable. Okay? So you'll find out. It depends on your fuel. It also depends on your atmospheric pressure. If you're at 4,000 meters altitude, like in the Altiplano of Bolivia, you need more air. So it's rules of thumb, but you don't have a calculation. There are people who pretend to have calculations. Like this, where's the conveyor unit? The hand stove?
Yeah.
Here. That one is 1/6, or 1/5. 1/6.
1/6, the primary air?
Yeah. You can actually count the holes if you want to. That is as per by the book. But reality isn't always perfect.
So for instance, the hole, 1/6 of the book.
How do you calculate that?
No,
so
that's what
yeah.
you mean.
Yeah, 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 yeah,
yeah,
yeah, yeah. Sort of. So
measure.
This is also why we make these holes here smaller than the big holes on the top. So, you see this, the can is just lower than the other one, which I also like, because then people cannot overfill it. We've had it that if you have a can like this where the secondary air holes are incorporated in the container, people fill it up to here. Here, naturally, they fill up with a little heat here maybe, but not too much. That is why I just make that gap 2 fingers. That is the problem of these units that come from India. This one is still okay, but the problem is that container is only held by these 3 tabs. If I place this, for example, on something like this here and I cook on it, I press this whole unit down because these things are flexible. And I've seen units, even for our X-Factory, where this then gets nearly up here. If you don't notice that, and you don't know how this thing functions, you still try to use it. I just talked to Paul Anderson and told him that this is not a good idea. This is why I really like something that cannot be moved, like this. These legs, they're just perfect. That's what I'm gonna do. So, who starts building? Got hands here?